Welcome to Denver Startup Week. I'm Ben Data, co-chair of DSW. This year marks the 10-year anniversary of Denver Startup Week. This community has been the catalyst for lots of change over the past decade, and this week we're coming together to celebrate the past and dream big for the future. We are able to bring Denver Startup Week to this community thanks to our 2021 sponsors. Thank you to our HQ and title sponsor, Amazon, and our title sponsors, whose leadership makes this week come to life. Capital One Cafe, Downtown Denver Partnership, Fluid Truck, Hotel Engine, and WeWork. And our track sponsors, who have made all of the great content you're hearing today possible. Founder Track, Kickstart, Growth Track, Friday Health Plans, Developer Track, Quizlet, Product Track, Palantir, Designer Track, Battery 621 in the Public Works, People Track, Exactly, and Spotlight Event sponsor, Strat Labs. Our headline event sponsors are bringing the excitement this week. Thank you to B-Side Fund, Colorado Public Radio, Comcast, Coors Brewing Company, Denver Pavilions, Entrepreneurship at the University of Denver, Gusto, JP Morgan Chase, Method, Moss Adams, Pine Insurance, Promontory Mortgage Path, Red Bull Basement, Southwest, Tattered Cover, and VF Venture Foundry. Finally, thank you to our partner and member sponsors listed on the screen. Please say thank you to these companies as you enjoy our Hybrid Denver Startup Week. And don't forget to use hashtag Den Startup Week to share your experience and moments of inspiration on social media. Have a great week.
The Public Works is a Denver, Colorado-based design, fabrication, and multimedia marketing firm that allows your company to craft an authentic presence to your target audience. For the past 15 years, the Public Works media team has been telling stories with words, pictures, and films. Our unique approach to brand storytelling allows us to get strong reactions and results from our content. We work in experienced and nimble teams with our crew of producers, directors, and cinematographers that all have firsthand experience and international presence. We are fortunate to have amazing clients that allow us to get wherever we need to go with the right tools for the highest production value. Lots of people can take a pretty picture. Just look at Instagram. But we believe our images speak for themselves. What really sets us apart is our decades of experience, our network, and our ability to make shit happen when it counts. We love bringing unexpected partners together to create added value for everyone, and most of all, we love when we finish a job confident that we've not only executed, but elevated the end product, and we know that everyone involved enjoyed the process. Our company was founded on the idea that life is about learning and teaching through every experience. We apply a strict discipline of work hard, play hard, and make great fucking work. We amplify awesome. We surround ourselves with the best and feed off of infectious innovation, ideas, collaboration, and building long-term friendships and partnerships. Contact us anytime for a meeting at our office, golf course, or on the chairlift.
Hi everyone, welcome to Denver Startup Week. I'm Castle, the Designer Tech Chair and member of the Denver Startup Week Organizing Committee. Thank you for joining us for the 10th anniversary of Denver Startup Week. At Denver Startup Week, we strive to make all of our sessions a space where attendees can connect, learn, and grow, regardless of age, gender identity, gender expression, race, ability, or sexual orientation. A special thank you to our sponsors for their support in helping us keep DSW free and accessible for all, especially our Designer Track sponsor, Battery 621, and the Public Works. Thank you for joining us and have a great week.
Hello, everyone. Welcome. My name is Stacey Hodges. I'm the community manager here at Thrive Ballpark, and I want to thank you for joining us both live and virtually for the presentation, Social Media for the Antisocial, presented by Hey Mister Digital Media. for this year's Denver Startup Week. We are thrilled to have Hey Mr. Digital as one of our members here, and I hope that the rest of our members can attest to the fact that we don't want to give those working in our co-working space simply a desk or an office. We want to be an extension of your business. We want to create what can be considered a partnership with you. So if you or anybody that you know is interested in the space or is looking for a home base for their business, either hit me up after the presentation or set up an appointment for a tour online. We're happy to help get everybody set up. And if this isn't the space for you, we'll help you find what works. With all of that said, I'm going to hand the microphone over to Avery with Hey Mr. Digital, and we'll kick this thing off.
Awesome. Yes, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for coming today for Hey Mr. Digital Media's first ever Denver Startup Week presentation. Yes, we're so stoked that you could come visit us in person, despite the awkward intro there. Appreciate you guys hanging in there with us. And if you are joining us virtually, please click the link in the chat so you can follow along and download that presentation. You're here today because you're frustrated, right? You know you need to be on social media. You know that 80% of users follow a brand on social media on Instagram, and you want to be one of those users, but or those brands that they're following, but you either don't know where to start or all the things that you've been doing aren't working. Well, you're in the right place, because our goal at the end of this conversation is that you feel ready and prepared to make your strategy as cohesive, professional, and confident and awesome as possible. We're going to shed you of that wallflower status and make you the most popular kid in the social media school. And by the way, we are going to be talking about some broad stroke themes here. So I highly encourage you to follow us on socials, check out our blog. We will be posting a very more detailed than this slideshow version, so you can do your homework later, class, and follow along. Because at the end of the day, marketing yourself on social media is actually one of the best ways to grow brand awareness. It's relatively free or very inexpensive. You can have the opportunity to create all of these amazing portfolio pieces and testimonials to impress those referral clients and potential new customers. And then, of course, you can engage with your audience, grow your followers, and all of this momentum will snowball, growing your clients, growing your revenue, and growing your business. So speaking of business, I would like to tell you a little bit about Hey Mister. We are a digital marketing company right here in Denver. Our office is at Thrive, and we specialize in website design, video production, and of course, social media management, and a little bit of everything in between. So if you need help with PPC ads, Google ads, email marketing, you name it, we got you, because our goal is to be an educator in the space, which is why we're here today. So if you find yourself feeling a little lost after this presentation, find someone in a pink shirt and say, "Hey, mister," and we'll help you out. My name's Avery. I'm a marketing director here at Hey Mister, and I have a background in theater and acting, and from storytelling to the stage to social media, I've got your back. So today we are going to be talking about your story and your brand's story and all of the amazing artistic things you can do. And I'd like to introduce my friends here, because they are going to be speaking on some points here as well. So thank you again.
Hello, my name is Alyssa Bresco, and I'm an account manager here at Hey Mister, which basically just means that I obsess over your brand story and elevating that online presence. I've loved curating and creating content on my own adventures for my clients and back when I received my degree in journalism and media communication. So excited to talk about TikTok today with you all.
Hi everyone, my name's Maddie and I'm the social media coordinator here at Hey Mister. I'm an East Coast native, and similarly to Avery and Alyssa's creative degrees, I have a dance degree from Hofstra University. So all you wallflowers, join the party and get new audiences like never before. Social media and high school have a lot in common. It's an uncharted territory, and there's a whole new set of rules. There's popular kids and the wallflowers and a ton of people in between that you don't know. So the challenge with the brand is, how do you separate yourself from that clutter and let your potential audience know who you are and what you do and separate yourself from that crowd? So the key is a well-designed strategy using all the latest social media knowledge available to you. So let's dive in and discuss aesthetic and consistency, a posting strategy with a clear set of goals, creating content that's optimized and will reach your potential audience, and engaging to get more followers and create real relationships. So first, let's talk about aesthetic. You want to think professional and consistent. So first off, let's look at your brand colors, your logo, and fonts. And you want to make sure that that's consistent across all your marketing platforms, not just social media. So think your website, newsletters, blogs, all of it. You want it to be the exact same. Then you want to create a brand guideline so that whoever's posting the content, if there's certain people posting on social versus the newsletters, they know the look and it's going to look the exact same. And then you want to look at filters. So you do want to keep in mind the Instagram grid, and you want it to have a professional, cohesive look. We recommend that you choose a filter for your photos. And then you can also add in, there's photos, of course, and then you can add videos or graphics. We do recommend with graphics that you use them sparingly but strategically, and that there's not too much text on those graphics. But a good workaround, if you do want to use those, is to use the cover of a reel, add a graphic to it to give your feed a more professional look, and the graphic will be more optimized. So let's talk about a posting strategy. You want to think, why am I sharing what I'm sharing, and what do I want people to do with it? Social media is just one piece of your marketing strategy, and there should be an end goal with it. We get asked a lot, will social media give me more clients? And the answer is it can, but we prefer to look at insights when we're looking at social media. So think engagement, click-through rates, followers, et cetera. But if you're a business, and you want more clients, a posting strategy can help with that by presenting you as the leading expert with testimonials and portfolio pieces. You can also create a relationship with your audience by asking questions and encouraging them to engage with your content. And finally, adding some strong call to actions in your posts to boost web traffic and get the phone to ring. So let's identify some content themes. So you want to take some time to understand your insights and see what they're doing. What are they sharing? What are they liking? What are they commenting on? And then also, what industry trends are you seeing? And complementary industries. What are they posting and sharing? And that's what you want to focus on. So some themes you could work with could be educational content, trends, company culture, reviews, etc. So keep track of those. Schedule some posts, see how it's going, and then you want to see what's working, what's not working, and don't be afraid to try something new. So you want to set a goal and create a plan to get there. So once you've created that plan, let's create some content. So if you think you have nothing worth sharing, you couldn't be more wrong. There's always something to be shared. So let's talk some inspiration and some of the tools available, and then finally some user-generated content. So here's just some general inspiration for your posting strategy. Client testimonials with a graphic, but as we mentioned, graphics don't always perform well. So if you can, get a photo, or if you can snap a quick video testimonial right there. We also recommend showing off what you do with portfolio pieces. You can share your opinion on a trending industry topic with a video or a reel. The stats show that how-to tutorials perform the best. So create what's gonna work well for your industry and try out that. You can also share company culture, awards, recognitions, behind the scenes footage. If you're working on something, set up a time lapse and either post that onto your grid or post that on stories, depending what works best for you. And then finally, you can try a trend. So jump on a trending hashtag and see and get more reach. So as we mentioned, the creative ways to create content or and share content are limitless. Let's touch on user-generated content. It's one of the most effective ways to reach your audience. And so why do we love it so much? It's basically the social equivalent word-of-mouth recommendation. And it's a very effective way to build trust with your customers. UGC gets more engagement and then branding content. And it also saves you time because the content's already out there and you're just resharing it. So some strategies we recommend to clients are hashtag campaigns or asking your clients to share and tag you in photos. So here's an example from a brand called Viva Dogs. They asked their followers to use hashtag Viva Dogs and share and tag them. And they've built out an entire user-generated content feed solely just from people tagging in them. So sometimes it seems small, but just the chance to be featured on a feed gets you user-generated content. So if your service or business is an in-real-life experience, you want to make it fun, make it memorable, make it grammable. You've probably seen some neon signs like the one here right at Thrive or at a hair salon or a restaurant having a QR code to snap a foodie pic and tag them in it. So you kind of want to do whatever makes the most sense for your business. We recommend getting them to tag them in photos. You could do a selfie, a before and after, really whatever makes the most sense for your business, and it doesn't hurt to try it. And so then if all else fails, you can incentivize your users with a contest. One thing to keep in mind with this, though, is that each platform does have some different rules. So you just want to do a quick Google search and kind of make sure you're up to speed on that before starting that contest. But you'd be surprised with any of those how much engagement you're going to receive. So speaking of engagement, it's one of the most important things when doing social media. So we get asked all the time, why is posting not enough and why do I have to engage with my audience? Posting is great and necessary, but you need to engage with your followers. If you think of going back to the most popular kid in high school, they had to engage with their network as well as reaching out to new friends to become the most popular person there. So it seems obvious, but it's the biggest worst kept secret that you have to engage to become popular. So basically it boosts your reach, gets more eyes on your page, and will help create relationships. And really, no matter the size of your followers, we recommend that you engage. If you spend a couple hours a week, you'd be amazed at just responding to comments in following complimentary brands, how much your growth, how many more followers you'll receive. So we recommend that you respond to every comment, every DM, follow back brands and users that make the most sense, follow complimentary brands and even competitors and see what they're doing. And just get your name out there. So just like in any relationship, these things take time, but are so worth it.
Sweet. Thanks, Maddie, for showing us all of the ways that you can create an epic content library and keep writer's block at bay, create a cohesive and professional aesthetic that is the same across all of your social media channels, and of course, engaging with your audience will grow your followers. And that is so important because if you think about it, a percentage of those followers will become customers. So you can put two and two together. The more followers you have, the more customers and potential customers you're going to be speaking to. So very important. A piece of content that we are going to dive deep into now in this post-pandemic climate, this form of content, video content, is going to help you grow your followers, and we're going to talk about that now. Like it or not, people are going to your brand's social media channels, okay? And they are expecting to see video content. They either want to see demo videos, they want to see how-to videos, they want to get to know you more and get to know your brand more before they make that IRL commitment. Everyone these days is making relationships through their screens, and creating a relationship with your brand is no different. They're going to stalk you on Instagram, watch all your videos, and then when they feel safe and cozy, they'll crawl behind that screen and actually pick up a phone to call you, book an appointment, make a purchase, etc. So lucky for you, there are tons of ways that you can incorporate video content into your social media strategy. One of the easiest ways is Instagram stories and Instagram story ads. If you look at the stat, I mean, 1 in 4 consumers made a purchase after seeing an Instagram story. So that is pretty powerful stuff that you can easily take advantage of. We also have 1 minute clips that you can post to the feed, your feed permanently. And then there's IGTV, which as of yesterday actually was rebranded into Instagram television. So side note, check your IGTV apps. They're probably going to be disappearing soon. But anyway, there's also Instagram Reels, of course, which we will definitely dive deeper into here in a second. So in addition to audiences expecting to see video content from you, there's actually a deeper strategy at play here, and that is called praising and pleasing the Instagram algorithm. The Instagram algorithm is so important, and posting video content will help you get more reach. Some of these quotes here I find so powerful. We've got Adam, the head of Instagram, saying that literally video content is going to be their first and foremost focus moving forward. And then as Hootsuite pointed out, Instagram Reels have become a key factor to getting more organic reach. So organic reach, back to what we're talking about here. Organic reach is so great because you don't actually need a paid ad strategy to get yourself there. You can just simply use the tools at your fingertips, the platform-specific tools like Instagram Reels and Instagram Stories consistently. The more you use it, the more that algorithm is going to recognize you as a valid user, the more reach you're going to get, the more eyes you're going to get, the more engagement you're going to get, the more followers you're going to get, and you see where I'm going, the more customers you're going to get. So if you're still not convinced on the power of video and how it can influence users and customers, check out these stats. They're pretty sweet. All right, let's dive deeper into Reels. As promised, we will talk about Reels today. Again, this is a broad stroke. I really want you all to take this presentation with you later and watch it and see what makes sense to you. But anyway, Reels can be up to 60 seconds long. You can record video in the app, or you can upload video from your camera roll. And then from there, you can add all of these cool features. One of the best features is music, and you're gonna hear us say this a lot. If you add music to your content, whether it be a Reel or later we're going to talk stories, Alyssa's going to talk TikTok, trending songs will please that algorithm and will boost your reach. So always think trending songs. And then once you've got your song in there, you can add text. And then once you've got your whole video together, we're going to show you really quickly how you can optimize the content with a caption. Less is more with Reels. With other forms of Instagram content, honestly, write a lot, but with Reels, 1 to 2 sentences is fine. Hashtags, I do recommend that you start with a lot of hashtags. You can do up to 30, and then once you get your momentum, it's been a couple months, you're getting thousands of views on your Reels, which you will, believe it or not, you can kind of wean off the hashtag, because nothing makes a brand look more desperate than having too many hashtags. Am I right? Okay. Another key thing that you should take away from this is, as Maddie mentioned earlier, graphics are awesome because they make your feed look really professional and cohesive, but they don't perform that well. So add a, can we go back really quick? I'm sorry, I'm still talking about Reels. By adding a cover photo to your reel, make it a graphic. That's a great workaround. And then, of course, always select the crop image there, because you're taking a 9x16 reel cover and you want to make it that 1x1 square. And you want to make sure it looks good once it's published. Okay, so that's kind of how to optimize your reel content in a nutshell. And now we're ready to talk stories. So Instagram stories are great for authentic, quick, and fun content. They're only 15 seconds long, and they publish for 24 hours. You can save them to your profile as highlights like we're showing here. So if you do have some portfolio pieces, this is a great opportunity to toss it on your story, save it as a highlight, and there you go. The latest stats are showing that more and more users are watching stories than they are looking through their feed. So posting stories daily, multiple times a day, is crucial. That doesn't mean you should stop posting to your feed. Posting to your feed is great, but take a quality over quantity approach with that feed, and feel free to lay on as many stories as you want throughout the day. So let's transition and talk about story ads. If you have an ad campaign or you're thinking of starting one, I highly recommend you check out Instagram story ads for kind of all the reasons we just went over. And I've got some quick tips for you. Always film vertically when you're talking stories and when you're talking reels and when you're talking TikTok here in a second. Vertical video is the wave of the future. And always be authentic. The more unpolished look you can be with your Instagram ads, the better. There's kind of a psychological play here. People are mindlessly scrolling through their stories, right? If they see an ad, they're going to skip it and they're not going to watch it. So you don't want to be that person. You want to kind of trick them, make it look authentic, make it look like something their friend posted. Like we've got the water drop example here in this coffee brand that's also entertaining, and they will watch it. So that is our quick little tips with ads. And now we will talk organic stories. This window should look familiar to you. It is the sticker window in a story. And if it's not familiar to you, check it out right now on your phone. There's all these great things to optimize your stories and get more reach. We've got a location tag. That means if you plug in a location, people are looking at it, they're gonna see your story. And it's free to use, so use it. We also have my favorites, which are the polls and the quizzes. This way you can see what your audience is thinking and engage with them and create more interest, and you'll be surprised what people respond with you. Now let's move to the next slide. Yes, okay, so if posting to your story daily, multiple times a day, sounds really overwhelming and scary to you, here's a quick hack. At Hey Mister, we call this sharing curated content. So in this example, I've got Hey Mister sharing a post from Denver Startup Week. It is a industry partner for us. It is a complimentary brand. So think about it and what makes sense to you. Is there a piece of information that your audience is gonna find valuable? Share it to your story. So that is a quick way to engage with other users and get yourself a story. So it's a win-win. The next slide, we're going to go over briefly on a really cool hack where you can share your brand's colors to your story. So if being cohesive is very important for your brand and professional, this is great. You're going to share your brand story to your camera roll. You're going to use the camera roll sticker in the Instagram story feature to get those brand colors onto your story. And then from there, there's amazing little text features. Here we're getting this marker effect by using the Comic Sans font and typing in a bunch of spaces to get that streak. And then we can put a Times New Roman kind of font over it. So again, broad strokes here. I really encourage y'all to follow us on social, get this presentation and follow along later at your own leisure. But anyway, next I wanna talk GIFs. Everyone thinks GIFs are just for cute characters, which they are. But if you think outside of the box and type in a keyword like shape or square or line or even individual letters like A, B, C, you'll be surprised at all the cool options you have to really make your story stand out and look pro. So there you have it. Some quick tips on how to do a reel, how to do a story, how to take advantage of these tools to grow your organic reach and get more eyes on your content. And I can't wait to hand the mic off to Alyssa, who is going to give us the rundown on TikTok.
Ooh, thank you. All right. So I'm going to chit chat about TikTok today, which most of you should have heard of. But this app is a force to be reckoned with and something you can use and harness to use that short form authentic video for your brand. Now, TikTok was intimidating from the start. It was launched in 2018 by a Beijing-based tech company called ByteDance, and they quickly absorbed TikTok's competitor, Musical.ly, and merged those users right onto one platform that you see today. Now, you may think of TikTok as just an app where people point to blocks of text on screen or where the kids bust a move, but it is so much more iconic than that. Go ahead and slide for me, hon. So actually, if you check out these stats, it was the most downloaded app in the world in early 2020. Just last month, it passed 1 billion monthly users. And to date, TikTok has reached 3.2 billion installs. So pretty impressive, I would say.
I find the most interesting thing about TikTok success is how it's making other apps make moves. So Instagram launched Reels last August, Snapchat introduced Spotlight, and YouTube is noticing how much time users are spending away on TikTok. As Avery kind of mentioned, Adam Mosseri, the head of Instagram, was like, "We're no longer a photo sharing app or a square photo sharing app," he said, which was kind of a fun one for photographers to hear who had been posting their work on Instagram for a decade. But Adam is not poo-pooing that. He is saying, please lean into video now, lean into entertainment. That's where we're all going. TikTok, you may think it's not for you. Plug this in your mind. TikTok is for everyone, and everyone's on TikTok. Okay, you can take a look up here if you can see these tiny little numbers. 28% of users are under 18, yes, but 19% are 39 and up. And then we've got this giant chunk in the middle here. So pretty spread across the board. Now, you've heard how big the pool is. How do you get noticed on TikTok? Just like a wallflower at the high school dance, you're just waiting to step out onto the floor. And that's all possible via the mighty For You page, which is kind of the homepage of TikTok. And it's just gonna show you a constant feed of videos tailored to what you like, what you comment on, what you save, what's popular, even a couple of new suggestions in the lottery. Also, don't miss the discovery page. This is your hub for trending hashtags, trending sounds, which can be original or popular music from the TikTok library, even trending effects. So when you're on here, you'll notice that the most popular people are sharing an original sound or taking another creator's work and making it better. So what is your thing? TikTok has it all, just like your other platforms. I mean, there's singers, teachers, cooks, entrepreneurs, popular culture. Okay, you can go down any of these avenues and find what you're looking for. And that's kind of the point. Brands that stick with something find success. Find your niche. So how do you provide value? What is your business known for? If it's tips and hacks, great. If it's humor, channel that, pick a direction. Now, a part of that is a posting schedule, that consistency, okay? So with TikTok, to make the algorithm happy, it's gonna be just about a post a day, which I know may sound a bit intimidating or exhausting. This is video. But you'll notice that users are not putting a lot into their production, but into their intellectual property, into what is shareable, into what's approachable. They're not spending a lot of time editing a polished video, so you can post daily. So there is the creator account versus the business account. Which one's for you? I'm gonna swap the question back to you. Is professionalism and brand awareness more important, or is being approachable and entertaining a bit more important at this stage in the game? So think about that for yourself, because as a business account, you're gonna lose some of those sound features that make TikTok so shareable. But as a creator, you may not have those analytics, scheduling, ads, and links that are handy for your business. Duets. I love duets. So this is the way to connect now. This is the way to make friends. This is the way to build off of each other, create something new. You can ask people to duet you. Now, what you see here is this young woman shared an original song and she performed it on TikTok. It's a great one. And then this young man harmonized with her. He duetted her. And furthermore, this woman duetted the both of them and they created this beautiful medley together. It went viral. And that just makes me think, what is my medley? What's your medley? What can your brand do to stand out, partner with somebody? Whose attention do you want to grab with duets? As an example,
Hey Mister posted one-sided interview questions and encouraged people applying for the position to duet us. So in that way, they could concisely answer these fun interview questions, kind of an improv moment, all on TikTok. So this app is all about authenticity and being yourself and kind of this unpolished aesthetic. And again, like we've been talking about, user-generated content. So big brands know this well. They're not going to just drop a polished advertisement on the For You page. They're going to post something kind of like Avery was saying, what your friend might send you, or they're FaceTime calling you and they're like, hey, this is pretty cool. Check this out. Amazon, boom, we have this nice tech guy here. Maybe he's one of your buddies. He's showing off his latest purchases. This Elf advertisement, this is a young mom who needs to get ready on a budget really quick. And she's just sharing her routine on TikTok. So they're targeting these demographics and we've got to be sneaky, right? A great tool, I think, for brands is answering comments via another TikTok. So if someone asks a question or leaves a comment, you can address it right on screen. And it just creates more of that interaction and engagement and sharing of knowledge with your followers. So hot tip, if there's something you'd like to answer, have an employee leave that comment and answer it publicly as a brand. Sounds are king on TikTok. You can see it will be labeled in red here. If the sound is original, that means one creator published that sound, and everyone else who's utilized it follows. And what this means is it's time to jump on those trends. If you see something trending or something, even Taylor Swift herself got popular, there's usually a way to tailor it to a business. Hashtags, we know hashtags from Instagram. It's a great way to find people or for people to find you. Now, the discovery page offers all of the trending hashtags of the moment. So that's a resource right there. Grab 1 to 2 from the discovery page and put that in your next TikTok post. Just more feeding of the algorithm. Good stuff. And of course, you won't find a wall of text or a wall of hashtags like you may see on Instagram. Optimize your content for this platform. The TikTok should speak for themselves. Cross-posting. So maybe you all have started on Instagram, like most of us, and you're comfortable making a couple of reels. I would save that in editing. You won't have a watermark then. I would publish that finished product to TikTok, add music from that platform, and boom, you have just hit 2 birds, 1 stone. And then it just saves time for your business, and it's a great way to drive traffic between those channels. So basically, we have short attention spans. Thanks for being here. Users want short form video and entertainment. Short videos and entertainment, that's it, okay? I'm sorry. Use these tools and features mentioned, but also investigate some others like the green screen effect or going live on TikTok. Please the algorithm. And remember, if you are mostly unpolished, completely yourself and unapologetic, you will have the attention of the room and become the popular kid in class or at least on the For You page.
Okay. Thank you, Alyssa, for sharing all of that awesome information. I know I learned something. Okay, as we wrap it up, I just want to leave you guys with some free software tools that if you're an entrepreneur and you're out here on your own, these will really save you a lot of time, and they're amazing. If you haven't heard of Canva, I honestly feel sorry for you. Sorry, but Canva is amazing. It's free. It's got all of these great great preloaded templates that you can easily plug in your brand colors and just go from there. So all of those graphics we discussed that make your Instagram feed look so professional, you're going to get them on Canva. Next, I really personally love Planoly. Not only can you just plug in your Instagram account, you can see your feed, you can actually plan your whole weekly schedule in there and see the feed before you publish, but they also offer some additional insights in addition to what you just get for free on Instagram having a business account. And I really like their newsletter. They send it about bi-weekly, and it has all of the latest and greatest Instagram tips and ideas. So free shout out plug for Planoly. Okay. I also really like $80 if engagement is your number one focus right now, but you don't have the time. $80 allows you to plug in your custom comments. You can target people via hashtags, and literally $80 takes care of the rest. It's not a bot because it does have those customized features, but it's really awesome, easy, and free. And then last but not least, we have Linktree. So I'm sure you've noticed you can only have one link on your Instagram bio, one link on your TikTok bio, one link everywhere. Linktree, as the name implies, is a tree trunk, one link, and then you click it, and then it branches off into all these other awesome things. So you can always reference that link in bio when you have Linktree. And I think we're done, guys. So thank you so much for coming in person. I want to shout out Miranda, who's been operating our slideshow, and shout out to Mike, who's live streaming all of this for you guys now. Woo! And if you have any questions, find someone in a pink shirt and say, "Hey, mister," and we will help you out. So thanks again, everyone. Cue the DJ. We need some music.